first of all, let me just say thank you to Student Council for their help. We have two Student Council members who are going to usher our honored guests to their seats. So we are going to go ahead and start our program with that.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to New York Island.
Took time out of your day to come here so we could honor you on this Veterans Day weekend. And we do really appreciate your service. I come from a family of veterans. Sorry, no Navy people in my family, but we have Air Force, Army, Marines. So, but what we'd like to do, first of all, we'd like to see what branch of the military you are with. So we're going to have you stand as we name them. And then we will cheer. Boys and girls, if we could just cheer kind of at the end, otherwise we won't hear the next one. All right, so if you are, okay, we'll go with the Navy first. If you are Navy, any Navy people? Okay, a couple Navy, woo, all right. How about Army? Who's our Army? Army, okay. There we go, lots of Army. How about Air Force? We should have a lot here. We've got Luke right around the corner. Oh, this is the Air Force side. You're on the wrong side, Mr. James. You're over here. How about Marines? Any Marines? All right. How about Coast Guard? How about, this is the new one, right? Space Force. Anybody Space Force? Okay. Well, thank you for being here. We do appreciate your service. And I wanted also just kind of on a personal give a shout out to two of our own staff members. We already said Mr. James. And if you didn't know, Miss Madewell, is it Air Force Miss Madewell? Air Force. So thank you, all of you, for your service. And I'm actually going to turn over the rest of the program to our students. So we're going to start with Brielle and Ella, our MCs.
Welcome and thank you for being here today. We want to especially welcome our guests, the veterans, and the active duty of our armed forces. Today we honor you and let you know we are grateful for your commitment to our nation. You have given your life, time, energy, and love to the United States. Thank you for your time, bravery, and sacrifice for this country. Thank you for your service. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by Addison and Harper.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated as Ms. Hunt sings God Bless the USA.
And I had to start again with just my husband and my kids. I think my life lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still. To the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. An American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today.
Students wrote essays about why our soldiers are important and why we should honor them. We are going to have the winners share their essays with you.
First, we have Colt Walker from first grade.
Our veterans are important because they fought for our freedom. They sacrificed in their lives for us and the boys. My dad is a veteran, and he sacrificed time with me, my sister, and my mom while he was in Afghanistan. We can thank our veterans by saying, I love you to them. We can also thank them for their service. It is important to thank veterans to show them we appreciate all they have done for us.
Next, we have Charlene Coleman from second grade.
United States military veterans deserve to be celebrated because they are brave. They sign up to protect our country and keep us safe. They are real life heroes. We can show appreciation to veterans by respecting the land we live on and everything that lives on it. We also should follow the laws of our country so that it can be the safe home our military fight for. It's to be Happy Veterans Day.
Thank you.
From third grade, we have Brecken Bardell.
For all of the years that all of the veterans were fighting in the Army, I wanted to thank you because you and maybe your friends were risking your lives to make sure we have freedom. And although some people die, we thank them for their doing. So you got this, veterans. Keep going. You're the best for keeping our lives safe. Thank you so much.
Our next essay is from a fourth grade student, Maya Valesco.
I think that it is important for veterans to have a special holiday just for them because they risked their lives for our country and got separated from their families for a long time just for the people of our country. When veterans go to war, they go to other countries or other countries come here. Many people died in the war just to save our country. When they are separated from their families, they are really lonely and their families are worried about them. I would show my appreciation by saying thank you, giving them a little gift or a hug.
Our last and final essay is from a fifth grade student, Desiree Barra.
Veterans should get their own holiday. They should get their own holiday because they worked hard, they should be recognized, and it is the time for us to show our respect to those who have served. First of all, veterans worked hard for America. They went out and fought every day. Some even lost their lives. They spent their time keeping us safe and fighting. Veterans are very hard workers. Secondly, without Veterans Day, America would forget all about who fought and risked their lives for us.
When we recognize and honor these veterans, we allow generations of friends and family to realize, understand, to really understand, appreciate, and get a small glimpse into the sacrifices these brave men and women have given to the United States. Lastly, Veterans Day is a time to show our respect to those who have served. We can do that by acknowledging that veterans fought for our freedom and risked their lives whether or not we realized it or appreciated it. Veterans worked hard by serving critical roles during dangerous times to stop unstable situations from developing into another war or conflict. Those who put on the uniform deserve our respect and honor for their service to our country.
Thank you for coming and helping us celebrate the men and women who give their lives to serve our country and protect our freedoms. Our program will conclude with Mrs. Hunt singing our national anthem. When she is finished, we would like to celebrate each of you as you parade through our students. Afterward, please stop by the library for refreshments. Please stand for the singing of the national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Again, thank you, honored guests, for coming. We're not going to keep you out here in the heat any longer. So we're going to let you walk back up the way you came, honored guests. And if you would like to stop in the library, we have some refreshments for you. And then after that, boys and girls, teachers, you can take your students back for the last few minutes. Thank you for coming.